Hey Fuzzbo, how you doing? Good to see you this evening. I think the gain of my microphone's still a bit too high. I think. Let me just lower it a little bit. Just by a few clicks. See if that helps. Take it down to 15. See if that helps. Hopefully. Okay, test. Okay, that should be fine for now, I think. Hey, how you all doing? Good to see you. And well, I know this is a bit of an odd sort of stream I'm probably about to do for however long this goes on for, but it's despite what the title of the Twitter thing says, this is not a sweet state five. That is coming, but I will probably be doing that either sometime this week or before the end of the year. But this is something I just feel I need to mention right now because, quite honestly, I just feel it's worth mentioning. Just as a general thing, about me, about, stuff in general, I would say. Hope the mic isn't being too much of a pain with the fan's passive noise. I know that's it's coming up on OBS, but I hope it's not a problem for anyone listening to this. That's fine. Okay, that's good. So, I suppose really I need to link an article to sort of explain myself a little bit. Just to kind of explain where this has all come from. I'll link it in the chat so that it doesn't seem like I'm just doing something completely random out of nothing. Yeah, that's an article that I've read this evening, and it's made me realize something about myself as a person, really. And I was really tempted to leave this for Sweet State 5 and to kind of talk about it then, but I want to talk about it now because I kind of. Hang on a second, I'm a little bit over there. Yeah, I think that's a bit better. Just in general. So, this is going to be very hard for me to say because I don't often like talking about myself too much, as odd as that sounds. No, that's not fair. That's not fair. I should say more precisely, I don't like talking about criticizing myself too much, and that's kind of the problem that I have as this person some of you have watched for a while, maybe some of you a couple of months, some of you for years have watched ever since I was a live streamer in 2009. I've been doing this for nearly 10 years now. Will be officially 10 years next year when around autumn time when I first joined Dope Lives as a sort of experimental thing I did back then, 10 years ago. How the time fucking flies, eh? So, what I really kind of want to do with this sort of impromptu, oh look, the streamer's got a webcam and is talking about his personal problems kind of stream here, is I want to issue an apology to, I would say, anyone who's ever known me in general over the last 10 years via the internet, shall we say, who's known Suitepee or John Suitepee as I'm called nowadays, because my first name was leaked ages ago and I just sort of rolled with it. Also, I think Suitepee was taken on Twitch, so whatever. Doesn't matter. I want to issue like an apology for a lot of things, really. My actions, because... Well, to put it bluntly, the article that I just linked illustrates how a narcissistic person can fuck up things for everyone around them. And honestly, what I truly believe at this point is via my live streaming over the last 10 years, maybe not 10, maybe a bit less, I myself, not entirely as bad as a certain other person, but I myself, via live streaming in general, have been narcissistic in my actions on here and in the past on Dope Lips in general. And putting it bluntly, this is all my ex-father's fault. Quite frankly. Because he has fucked my life up, basically. And I'm not going to go into massive detail about that here. But I want to illustrate that's where it's come from. But it doesn't excuse what I've done. Honestly, you know. And I just wish to apologize for the way I've acted for 10 years of live streaming, basically. Maybe 9 years. It all started with Red Faction, and it's not been any better since then, really. It's not really... The specific problem that I've had hasn't disappeared since a stream I don't have recorded. But I remember it very well. And I wish to apologize to the Doom community. I wish to apologize to the Dope Lives community. And I wish to apologize to anyone in between those who's known me for a while, or for a little, for the way I've acted in the past. You know? And... Although, I am nowhere near as bad as my ex-father. I genuinely like to think that I've come across as a nice person. And do acknowledge when I've said something out of place or out of turn. And been really mean-spirited to someone that didn't deserve it in the heat of the moment. But... For the large part... I feel that I've said a lot of silly things regards trying to be perceived as this sort of intelligent streamer who wants to be liked, I guess, if you will. I guess. I mean, that's what narcissism is, you know. I have shown that trait across streams over the years, you know. And I wish to apologize for that, you know. I mean, I still recall with fondness the day when I played, for example, with Sunlust and my spiel of, oh, I only play on ultraviolence. I only play on one difficulty. I can handle it. Anything else that is difficult is bullshit, you know. And that Alfonso post... At the time, after I'd beaten map 20 of Sunwast, resonated with me very strongly, and ever since then, it was almost like learning humility, a sense of humility. You know, no, John, you're not as good as you think you are. You're not as good as you think at playing Doom. You know, you do need to tone down the difficulty for certain things. And ever since then, I've acknowledged that sometimes I need to do that. And that was a very necessary, humbling experience for me. And then, you know, that was just an example. And the way in which I have been so quick to criticize things that have been difficult for me, yet not realizing, you know, that it's really myself at fault, it has been, is the problem, is the core thing. It's something that has been mentioned to me over the 10 years I've been live streaming. It has come up again and again and again and again as a trait that I've had, still have to some extent. You know, I get frustrated easily, and it's not just that necessarily. You know, that's not going to go away entirely. That's going to happen. I can't change that part too much. It's just part of who I am. But what I can change is this somewhat, not really, it is really. It's the narcissistic thinking that somehow by being a sort of a live streamer and having played Doomwatch for a while, but I am somehow this worthwhile critic of what should and should not be in a Doom level. You know, it's that kind of mentality where it's like me saying that encounters should... You will have seen examples of this, right? Fuzz, is you the only one listening to this? You have seen examples of me saying stuff like that, you know, like, oh, this WOD should be like this, this WOD should be like that, you know, I think this part should be more difficult, stuff like that. You know, I'm not saying that all of what I've said isn't constructive criticism, but I'm sure there's been plenty of times where I run into a hard encounter. You have seen the sort of the stereotypical, the John Suitepee response to a difficult map or scenario, which is to flail forward at the situation and then fucking die a couple of times, get really pissed off, and not have that sort of presence of mind to see it for what it is, a difficult situation. And you know, it's not, to be clear, this is not about being frustrated because something is difficult. That's going to happen to everybody. I'm not. It's when I sort of think I know better. That narcissistic, false intelligence sort of thing, saying stuff like, I don't know, oh, this is bullshit. The fucking mapper shouldn't have done it this way. This is not how you do Doom maps. And you have heard me say that a lot, quite a fucking lot, actually, about certain things. I mean, I think the infinite height is stupid, but a lot of people don't. And a lot of people have grown up on infinite height and still use it in their maps and in their encounter setup for maps. You know? And when maybe that's not the best example to bring up. But you have heard me say this about many difficult situations or setups, you know. Me saying stuff like, oh, this is bullshit. Why didn't they put this here or that there or whatever? You know, this what is dumb. This mapper is an idiot. You know, that's sort of like sneering, narcissistic criticism that I sometimes apply in the heat of a moment, and yet supposedly my goal is to encourage mappers, you know, to want to be this nice guy. It's like, it's to try and describe it to you, it's like me saying, I want to be able to criticize this mapper for doing this thing because they made me sweat and I didn't like it, and at the same time me saying that I also want to be this nice person who tries to encourage mappers with to make more stuff, you know, to do things. And obviously, you know, I really do want to encourage and provide good criticism and encourage people in the Doom community to do other things, to keep making stuff. And sometimes there are things that are genuine mistakes, and I do point them out. And I tried to be fair, but it's those moments where it's someone makes a difficult map. I don't appreciate it. It's not that. It's not that I shouldn't be able to criticize something. It's when I say I'm criticizing it because this isn't how it's supposed to be. The difference between it being a criticism of genuine constructiveness and a criticism just because I find it difficult, so therefore this is bullshit. Doom should not be this way. Doom should not be this way. This is not how maps are made. You know, you don't put 10 revenants in a fucking closet and fucking unleash them when you cross this line death. You don't put fucking archvows there. Where's the fucking cover mapper? This is bullshit. It's not that I should. It's not that, you know, some kinds of map aren't going to be fine for me. But it's that sort of conflicted, narcissistic thinking of me being, I'm this nice guy, I'm this great personality, I'm a fucking nice person, but God forbid you chuck a difficult encounter at me, and I will fucking call a mapper out, I'll call him a cunt, I'll call him a dick. And sometimes they are being dickish, to be fair. Hey, Benjo Garmi, how you doing? Sometimes they are being dickish, but that's the point. That's the point. That's what they want to do. And I can't be narcissistic about my genuine level. I'm not that good at Doom. I suck compared to other people. You look at Nivanos, he's very good at Doom. You look at Mr. Zul, Elmley, all these speedrunners, these other people, you know, they have played for years, they have this calm approach. I don't have that. I'm not as good as them, and I never will be. Because I don't possess that desire for practice or whatever the fuck it is. I'm a casual who narcissistically sometimes think isn't a casual. And that's where the problem is. Hey, Scotty. Well, I don't do it consistently. And even so, that's not the point. The point is that I think in the past I have been guilty full sail of criticizing a map because I found it difficult. Me. Not because the map is in the wrong, because I'm in the wrong. I haven't been able to say, I find this difficult, but maybe the map is good. And it's gone on for too long. This sort of thinking, I don't want to do it anymore like that. That's not fair. That's not what I should be doing. I have this narcissistic thinking, and it comes from my ex-father. It sucks. It's fucking terrible. You're not bad at doing when you put your mind to it, but finding that way of getting around an issue is what you need to work at. Well, exactly. And that's what I'm trying to do. And that's why I'm doing this on a stream. I owe a lot of people an apology. How many mappers have I called cunts when I've just found things hard? I mean, I still remember when... what was it? The 1028 project. It was... Who was it? It was 1028 Putinia. I think it was Putinia something. I'm pretty sure it was a 1028 project. I think it might have been put in here a few years back. And I think it was that. The mapper themselves will know, if they're here now, the mapper themselves will know who it was and what I'm referring to. I've forgotten. But I remember a few years ago when I was just playing a tricky small map and I burst out with a comment. I called him a cunt. And they did not like that. And I realized there that I'd crossed the line a little bit. I'd said something, you know, a little stupid, you know, frustration, just the frustration of it. But that kind of stuck with people for a while because you have heard me, Chewy, Benjo, Scotty, you have heard me say stuff like this in the past. You know, I've been very narcissistic in my thinking, you know. I've criticized when Tarnsman made that post about how while revenants are a pain in the ass, what's a bigger pain in the ass is the crossfire of lots of enemies with static projectiles because you run into the back of them. And I'd be raging at him, and I'd be raging at anyone who dared criticize me. You know, I know best at Doom. They're just fucking Doom Illuminati or whatever. You know. And I've done this for years. if I struggle in a game or a map, it's the game or the map that sucks at times. It's not me. I can't be possibly it. I can play on ultra violence. No, you can't. I can crack any map. Yeah, you can, but you can bang your head at it. Not fun. You know, it's just... I do remember some moments. Bone Vote comes to mind, by Ostan, I forgive you. Well, yeah, I would have done the same with you. And this is... Keep in mind, Benjo, this is me knowing, A, you were a slaughter mapper. B, you told me it was going to be difficult. And C... Okay, that's what's it. I know you as a slaughter mapper. I know you make hard maps. And I knew that. And I still called you names. I understand. It's not like I don't reserve the right to occasionally, if I'm frustrated, to say, fuck you, Benjogami. That's terrible. It's not that. I'm not going to be able to stop myself from doing that sometimes, because sometimes you do get frustrated, and sometimes you are allowed to give the mapper a fuck you. It's when I say stuff like, this is not how mapping should... It's when it becomes like... It's when it becomes like, I criticize the mapper for doing something that other people... Well, yeah, like a personal attack on him, you know. Saying like, Jesus fucking... You have heard me do this so many times over the years. So many times. It's almost embarrassing. I mean, there's probably very few mappers that have gone away with, like, no scathing criticism. And it's probably those mappers who have not died or had any difficulty. It's the same. It's the same. It's the same sort of ironic sort of hypocrisy, where I will say like on Cincy in Gold Morning Phobos, oh, this should be more difficult. You know, where's the difficulty? Where's the lock in? Which is a fair point, but knowing full well if he did that and he locked me in there and forced me to fight that out, I'd probably also be saying this is fucking bullshit. This is a difficulty curve. A swipe, a swerve, and I don't like it. And I'll get mad and frustrated, and then I'd almost want to go back to the sort of normal, the style of before. That hypocrisy of trying to be seen as this likable doomwad critic, but I go about it by attacking mappers for stupid, dumb shit, where it's me that lacks the ability. You know, and I can't keep doing that. You know, I mean, I know it's fun for somebody to watch me get upset, and if I get up frustrated at myself, at my inabilities, then fair enough. You know, I'm gonna get frustrated. I have that streak. I have that autistic trait, whatever the fuck you want to call it. Well, I get easily frustrated at difficult scenarios. That's never gonna go away, and you know, it can be. I watch other people get mad too. Sometimes. I don't know why. I should probably stop doing that, really. But it can be funny to watch like a someone who's in the competitive community saying that thing sometimes. But knowing full well that I do the same shit sometimes. Well, I don't map myself, true. But it's fine to say, well, this should be like this. But when you are put in the shoes of wanting to make something difficult... Well, yeah, I mean, I learned a few things by attempting to map. You know, I gained a little bit of appreciation, but it's my mental approach to playing a game in general, any game. You know, it's like anytime a difficulty approaches, I get frustrated and I don't learn from it, you know. It's why I don't play the PvP games anymore, because if I don't immediately start doing well and I get a few bad runs and I suck at those games, then I just quit. And I don't think that's a bad thing, because I'm getting tired of that kind of stuff, I think. You know? And I think I'm not a big fan of the Battle Royale stuff and the PvP and whatever. I can't see the fun in it unless I'm winning, I guess. Sometimes it has to be dickish, but that would be the map of wanting to make the challenge. Of course, it doesn't mean the player can't be constructive. Well, I can, and I know that I can. I tried to do that. I tried to provide the positive construction. I'm not saying all my criticism has been out of place. I'm saying a lot of it has in the past and still is. That mental approach that I take to difficulty is wrong. And I can't keep doing that. I can't keep just being this narcissistic asshole who wants to be seen as this fucking, you know, a respected member of the Doom community, but doesn't do anything to really respect in times of trouble, shall we say. It's like, oh, it's so easy when everything's going fine, but the moment a hard encounter comes and I start dying, I start swerving and calling the map a nasty names, and that's not how it should be. And a lot of this stems from me realizing how much of a shitty bubble I've been in for 32 years. But that article, I'll link it again for those who just joined in to look at. You know, that's what I read tonight, and that's what I realized. I am a part narcissist, and the part that is narcissistic comes out in my streaming. I almost want to be seen as good at Doom, good at something. You have heard me say it in the past, maybe, saying, like, I want to be good at something, respected at something, but not, you know. It's just that horrible thinking where I run across a difficult encounter, even if I know it's difficult, even if I know it's from a difficult mapper, and I still get frustrated in it, and I still swear and that's not really. I'm just ironically the complete opposite of what I mentally picture myself as trying to be like. You know, I'm an asshole. I'm a rage-filled fucking asshole. I swear at you because you made something difficult and I didn't like it. So I'm going to say fuck you a lot. And I'm going to call you all the words. And I'm going to say, you just know how Doom should be like. Doom should be like this. It should be something I can just breeze through first time and go, well, that was easy. You know, oh, I just pulled off this great maneuver of this map. This map should be more difficult. Oh, you made it more difficult? Fuck you. I'm going to slam things. I'm going to throw a keyboard across the room. I'm pissed off. Please respect me. I'm a likable fucking individual personality. Please respect me. I'm so sorry. All because I just want to be liked. All because of my fucking narcissism that I express for the last 10 years. Yeah, please hit that bell. Please follow. Please donate to this fucking cause. Which, incidentally, I fucking don't know why I... Well, actually, I don't mention that part, to be fair. I don't really mention it too much, because... Well, not as much as I could, because I'm not the most bothered. That target will hit it, but that's not the point. I'm not like that entirely. It's not like I'm a complete prick, but I am sometimes one. And more often than not, when people have called me out on it quite correctly, I've responded very poorly. You know, you have heard me say, you're trying to help me, and I say, shut the fuck up, your advice is wrong. You know, I've said it to people in the chat as well, they've been trying to help me, and I'll think it's an attack on me, and that's the narcissistic way of thinking. You know, you perceive a personal attack and you don't like it, so you lash out. But then I realize in the moment that I've done something stupid, and I realize it, and that's the difference between me and my ex-father. I at least recognize that I say stupid shit, and I should apologize for it, but what I should do is not say it in the first place. To teach myself not to do it in the first place. You know, I can't say here and now from this moment on, I'm going to turn into Nirvana. So I'm going to be completely chill and just play things and be like, oh, I died. Whatever the fuck, man. I don't care anymore. Hey, video gamer games. How's it going? Welcome to John Suitepee. Honestly, talks about himself for once. For the first time in 10 years. This is not a sweet state. This is something I have to... An apology to a lot of people over the years. I even forgot what I was mentioning now. Some intelligent person I am when I can't fucking remember my own conversation tangent because I forgot. Because I'm screaming hello to someone. But... What was I saying? Yeah, so... I don't know how many apologies I need to... It's just a general apology. You know, but sorry, I lost my tangent there. I need to get it back if I can. Yeah, that's it. I'm not gonna say that I'm suddenly gonna be this streamer that just fucking is super chill about every situation. I can't be like that. I tried that. I tried it. I realized that's not what I'm like. I can't be that kind of person. I can't be this fun, loving, chill individual who gets butt-fucked by revenants and just accepts it and just gets on with his day. I take things very seriously sometimes. I put effort into it. Maybe not as much as I could do, but I put effort. You see me care about this stuff. But that means I also take it way too seriously. And it would be nice if I could just not give a shit and I could play Fortnite or some other competitive, popular game and not care about winning or losing, but just enjoying the ride. But I can't. Because I'm a fucking narcissistic asshole. Or I can be sometimes. And I have been. Sometimes. And it's just realizing that. That's what I'm like. Whether I want to really admit it or not. But that's what I'm like. I've been for a while. You know? I mean, it's just so many apologies old to so many mappers or situations or spots where I've been swerving at people and calling people out for nothing, you know, and just my own poor, very bad behavior, you know. So, yeah, that's just what I've been like. And if you look back, you probably always, I guess whoever's watching, you could probably think of examples when I've been like that. Well, that's why I've wanted to do it. I was really tempted to really put this in the next sweet state, which I wanted to do like in the next couple of days or whenever. But I just want to mention this now because I would probably end up not while it's fresh in my head. I just had a conversation about it after I read it tonight, and I just thought, I owe a lot of people an apology. I owe all these mappers that I've badmouthed over the years for one thing or another, or just been really poorly behaved towards. You know, all these people I've called idiots, or you're saying things wrong because of my own intellectual narcissism, I guess. And I want to change from being like that all the time. Not that I'm going to stop being a streamer who will occasionally get frustrated because there's a difficult fight or whatever. That's not going to change. I'm still going to have that sort of side of me where I will get frustrated because three revenants shut up and killed me. And I still don't like revenants because of the damage variation and other reasons. But at the same time, I need to acknowledge maybe moments where I need to like stop playing for them or whatever is required to sort of be able to provide, I don't know, to acknowledge just when I'm frustrated at something and acknowledge that it's like it's just me that's struggling here. The map itself is fine, and to genuinely to say that, to express that, and to realize you're not as good as you think you are at this thing. It's all right to say it's hard, and it's all right to maybe, you know, I don't know, take a break for a moment from it, or to not be stuck in your rigid thinking, or not to just call them horrible names, or to claim that you know a lot about Doom when you really don't. To not try and be this narcissistic individual. To know, to stop pretending, oh, I know my shit, when I don't. You know, I'm very lucky I haven't been challenged to any, like, massively public criticism of my behaviors more often, I guess. But it's just, it can't go on like this. It's not fair to any honest mapper that deserves, you know, or to any person who's watched me for years flip side, it's fine to bring discussion and give me the chance to allow for rather than just bring shade. Well, of course there is a difference. Well, I don't know what you mean though with what you want to improve on. I just want to improve on my ability to sort of take a bad situation. I've been watching you since you started on Dollars and even before when you spread a half-life zombie mastermind. I just said that's the way you are. Well, it's very nice. Wait, you were in Suitepee? That really old clan I used to be part of? Holy shit, that was ages ago. And the fact I can remember their name. Wow. Emma Ward on Dope, yeah. Well, that's just it. That's just being seen as the way I am. But the way I am hasn't been acceptable. Amy and Mabel. Stuff balances, isn't it? Being respectful to mappers and giving constructive feedback while having and expressing your own feelings. And my own feelings have been an absolute fucking whirlwind since last summer. Not this summer, I mean last year's summer, I should say. I know what you did last summer. Slashy, slashy. Horror movie reference. Well, it is. And the thing is, Pineapple, is that that balance has been awful for me. Because I want to try and help I really genuinely do want to encourage mappers to keep making stuff. But at the same time, I'm so quick to just be an asshole in criticism. You know, while perhaps not as publicly saying, I mean, I think that I try to mention it, but it's the fact that I even go there in the first place. It's almost like at certain times when I'm in a difficult situation, I should just say, right, let's pause the game, let's just time out and go back to it in a moment when we've calmed down and we don't say things that are going to hurt, that is very unconstructive and poor. Because it's a single-player game. I could pause the game. I don't have to fucking die over and over again. And hey, Crouch, how's it going? And you've been working for a few minutes, and I know this is not a pity party, before anyone mentions that. I know that phrase. This is me being honest about what I've been like. Well, thank you, Carajo. I appreciate that. I'm not saying that I can't provide feedback that's useful. I know that I have helped a few people in the past. It's the fact that so many times I'm so quick to criticize for the dumbest reasons, and I come across as a dick because of my narcissistic thinking, which, and I have to admit, I need to get better at this kind of thing. I can't just keep acting like this, you know. I can't keep using live streaming as my escapism outward, where I'm allowed to curse people and act in a way I would never normally act in front of an actual person. You know, where I'm genuinely more emphatic and curving, I can't keep using live streaming as my narcissistic crutch to swear at people. Unnecessarily. And I think for the longest time, that's probably what I've ever done. That's all I've used live streaming as sometimes. Something is difficult. Fuck! Fuck! I'm allowed to let out my autistic rage. I'm allowed to swear and call people naughty names and be upset. Oh, I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. I want to be liked, though. No. You can't have it both ways, me. You either have to be genuinely nice and accept your faults, or you're just a dick. Or I'll get that ass banned. And pick one and stick with it. And I want to choose the side where I acknowledge my faults and try to genuinely be this nice guy that I perceive myself as occasionally being good at impersonating. You know? I can't really contradict you, John. Sometimes you do come across as a dick. I think you could do it better, but it's something you need to overwatch about it. I so love to see my match on your streams over years, so I think as a moment the world becomes legit. Watching you dad starts to get a bit frustrated. And I know that some people have thrived on that. Steve D, for some reason, I don't know why, relishes me dying on his maps. So he relishes in the masochistic pelt counting. But, you know, some people could take it, and I know that a lot more probably just, and I do, that's the problem. And even now I'm thinking, oh, I want to be liked, I want to, but no, it doesn't matter. Yes, even this is kind of me wanting to still be liked, but it's me sort of me more acknowledging to everyone that I owe people a lot of apologies for the way I've acted for years, years. This hasn't just come from Doom, this has been me on other games in the past, on Dolt Lives, everything. Ever since Red Faction. Because prior to Red Faction stream, a long, long time ago, I didn't really get too upset at video games on stream. But the moment, I could pin it down to one exact moment. And I still wish, for the love of God, that I had saved the recording of that stream. But it's gone to the mist of time, unfortunately. It was the first moment where I got so frustrated at something in a game that I shouted into a microphone. And prior to that, I had never shouted ever since. And this would have been in late 2009 or early 2010. I forget the exact date. But I remember it as clear as crystal. I was playing Red Faction 1, and it's the moment where you go up to the satellite control center, and it's the first time you come across the mercenary enemies with the guns that are really accurate. And they ambush you as soon as the cutscene ends. And it's a little cheap, but it's doable because you get the same weapon off them afterwards or whatever. And actually, to be fair, building up to that point, you'd actually been fighting a few of them on the way to the satellite tower. So you'd kind of fought them for a bit anyway. But it was at that cutscene where, like, you're seeing a satellite and then two of them show up behind you and you got to deal with them quick. And sometimes you just get killed because it's a bit cheap. You know, they ambush you a bit. And I died several times to that point, and yeah, in Dark Souls 1, I had a similar sort of thing. You can look at an old Dolt Lives video of me playing Dark Souls 1 before Alstein and Smog, and getting so mad. I actually took nearly a two-week break from playing games after that, but I came back and kicked their asses after three attempts. But yeah, absolutely. Dark Souls made me upset, but it was so satisfying to beat it. I don't mean to brag here, but I beat Dark Souls 1 by without using a summon. I did, however, follow something of a rough guide, so. But no. Two best friends played today. Oh, they've stopped as well, have they? Alright, didn't know that. No. I will not stop streaming. I can't. I've invested too much time in it, and I enjoy it. And because of it, I've met some great people. You know, Drauken, my moderator. I've met him several times in real life. I'm going down to see him after Christmas, actually. Again. I've met some great people by doing this, and you know, I will admit that right now, I do live stream far too much. I use it as my escapism. It's like, I'll just play RuneScape a few times, and then it's been 15 parts in, what, 2 weeks? It is still a chill stream project. I am still going to be playing a lot of Doom and FPS shit, whatever. But now, I actually tried to quit streaming for one place a while back, and the thought has crossed my mind on occasion. Well, yeah. I think it is. It's not that. It's not that I'm not here. Yeah, exactly. But I don't want to get that frustration and turn it into personal attacks on people or ways where I have no place or business really talking about. It's like if I played, oh God's sake, it's like when I have played games in the past, it's like, this is bullshit. I fucking hate this crap. And it's like, where the fuck are you coming from? Do you have any experience in knowing what is genuinely bullshit? Have you played so many maps over the years that you can really honestly judge what is and what isn't a bullshit map choice? And it's like, no, I can't really. I'm just a casual that plays Doom, that occasionally shows bursts of skill, but is mostly a rage-filled autist who just happens to have somehow built up a decent cult of personality, who acts like a narcissistic dick a good chunk of the time, and people don't respect that, and so they shouldn't. But yeah, exactly. Frustration is fine, attacking people, and that's the problem. I don't want to attack people. I don't want to call people these names sometimes. I do want to swear when I'm frustrated at a situation and then just move on and try and beat the situation. What I don't want to do is where I swear at the situation and then I say something like, this situation itself is bullshit, I don't like it, so therefore it sucks. Your use of revenants is poor. You're a terrible mapper. Fuck you. And even... Well, okay. I'm allowed to criticize E4M2 and say fuck you, Romero, because E4M2 is hard. I'm fine with that. Oh, God. Underselling myself. No, I genuinely think that over the years, you know, I'm sure you're very hyped, Pineapple, and I will get around to playing Nano Pineapple and the other things. That'll be next year, which isn't far off, come to think of it. It's the 16th of December right now, so two or three weeks, and it's 2019, and I can play what I want then. And I'm going to. I'm going to play all the WODs I've wanted to. Struggle. Golden Souls 2. Deathless. Mano Pineapple. Whatever I want to play, I'm going to play next year. That's my new policy. Hey, Wolf Army. I've just come to an honest sort of realization about myself after reading this article. Something my mom showed me, and some of it resonated very strongly with me. And I've come to realize that I've been a narcissistic asshole as a streamer for 10 years. In part, anyway. Not that I'm always... Well, yeah. I agree. At least I've possessed a sort of sense of self-awareness. But it's not good enough just to possess a sense of self-awareness. Because for how many fucking years have I said the same shit over and over again? It's about time I just did something about it. You know? I can't just sit here and keep saying, oh man, wouldn't it be fucking nice if I could just be chill stream and take on these encounters, and I still do the same fucking stupid shit over and over again. It's about time I actually started genuinely trying to stop doing that all the damn time. To genuinely realize it's the situation that annoys you because you're not good at dealing with the situation, and now you need to deal with it or not if you don't want to play it. And if I want to genuinely try to be this positive, constructive critic, maybe it's time I actually acted like one. Because a little bit of, I want to be helpful to people. That's what I'm like. I have a lot of empathy. It's what saved my life so many years ago. But sometimes I really show a lack of it. And it's about time I showed a bit more consideration when I'm saying and doing stupid things, you know. And that's why this stream is being done right now. Because I want to apologize to everyone. Every single time I've said a mapper's name and called their map shit because of... So not necessarily the mappers where it has been genuinely bad and improvements can be made, But for those mappers where the work has been fine, but I've just found it difficult, you know, I want to apologize to the mappers who have given me hard situations to deal with, and I've called them out and called them bad names. I want to apologize to the people who have tried to help me both in the chat or on a forum post or in general, and I've just turned around and swore at them, saying, you don't know what the fuck you're talking about. I am in control. I want to apologize to anyone who has been annoyed by my antics, who has, you know, rightfully said or thinks this guy's a dickhead. You know, it reminded me of when I got so annoyed at when that Arctangent made that post on Doomworld saying, from the face of it, this guy sounds like a right cunt. And I took umbrage to that. But in hindsight, she had a point. A really good point. Without knowing me or watching a lot of my streams, without sort of getting to know the general character, I come across sometimes as a bit of a cunt. I genuinely do. If I was a neutral watching a stream, and you just happened to caught me in a moment when I was playing, like, I don't know, a difficult map, or a difficult game, or a difficult situation, and you saw me gnashing my teeth and fucking muting my microphone and saying stupid shit, you would think I was a cunt, and you'd be right in saying that. Because that's part of what I do sometimes. It's why people loved it when I played Sunder, because I did that a lot, because Sunder was incredibly frustrating. And it is, and I still don't like Sunder in part because it's got some really awkward encounters, but I still beat it. But the point is that the way in which I talked about things, and the way that I went on about how insane gazebo, you know, my thoughts on Grindr, and I don't like that map, I really don't, but at the same time, why should I, who the hell am I to say, who the fuck told Insane Gazebo that map was acceptable? It's like, well, what if he thought it was fine? What if that person was a well-informed friend of his and thought he should put it out anyway because it's a different kind of challenge, you know? That's the kind of thinking where it's like, oh, you know, I'm so good at Doom that I could judge when on a notepad, based on a notepad file and a few words. It's about me being honest about myself, Corn King, for the narcissistic asshole that I have been for streaming for years now. That's what it's about. I'm sorry that the title isn't very clear, but I want to talk about this because of an article I read earlier. Well, it is. It's perfectly fine. Again, it's the thing, it's the fact that I can, it's fine to say this is horrible, this is difficult, this is unfair, but it's another thing to then call the mapper a dickhead, an idiot, and several other things, and to criticize not only Insane Gazebo for... Oh, sure, Conking, of course you've noticed. You could drop the sarcastic badger. Or sloth, it's a... I forgot to say, it's a sloth, not a badger. God damn it. It's that. It's when I go too far with it. It's when it doesn't become, John is frustrated at this encounter, he's upset, he's swearing at things because it's difficult. It's when I say, when I go too far and I call Insane Gazebo this, and I call his friends that, and I call it all stupid, and I even have so far in the past have called slaughter mapping and the slaughter mapping loving community stupid at one point. You know, Mr. Zool will be able to tell you when I've been inconsiderate for that. Yeah, thanks, Drowken. Thank you for your sarcastic support. Well, I might be too harsh on myself, but you know what? I've been too harsh to others. I deserve to be too harsh on myself. I deserve that criticism. I deserve to have this moment of enlightenment to realize that I've really been harsh on others. Imagine if, like, Insane Gazebo, imagine if he comes back and he wants, can you imagine if, like, Insane Gazebo came back today and he was like, oh, I'll just look at a random stream of, oh, this Doom streamer here, he's been playing Sunder, and I'll see what he thinks of Sunder. And that's why he is nothing but a tirade against this map. Shit, your shit, your shit, shitty shit shit. And he says, "Wow, I guess people don't like Sunder too much. I'll just walk away." You know? I have to be harsh to myself because I've been harsh to so many people for the stupidest reasons. I know that some of you could take it on the chin and you sort of get the point and you sort of get, I say stupid shit, but it doesn't excuse it. It doesn't excuse it at all. You don't excuse a murderer for having a tendency to kill people every so often. You don't excuse an abusive twat for being an abusive twat. And I shouldn't be excused for my actions either. I know this is kind of like a rant and I'm repeating myself, but that's my genuine feeling, and I've never said this before. But I feel this is something I've had to say right now. And it's not going to be an immediate thing. I'm not going to turn around and do the next stream. It's going to be great. But it's that realization, and I'm a narcissistic idiot. I don't know what I'm talking about, and perhaps I should stop pretending that I do. You know, I should just take it for what it is. Learn, you know, think better. If you don't know what a situation is, don't comment on it. Just, you know, try to overcome it and maybe become better for it by working around it. I have beaten a lot of tough fights by eventually... Oh yeah, thinking better would probably help. Exactly. Thank you, Drowker. You know, I want to think that in the future when I play a tough map, I try to overcome it. And it is satisfying to overcome a tricky situation. And it'd be more satisfying if I overcame it without calling the mapper an idiot. Unless it was like a genuinely bad setup. In which case they deserve to be criticized for the setup and how they should maybe improve said setup, but not criticized as an individual person for trying to do that setup. So, you know, that's what I want to apologize for. And you, Drowken, will know what I'm like of all people. You have seen me from day one. I've done this for years on Dope Waves. I've been poor at receiving criticism. I've been poor at trying to think differently. I've been poor at handling difficulty. I get upset. And then in real life, I'm not that bothered about it. Usually. I'm usually quite cool about it. And it's like, why can't I just be like that here? Why can't I just accept tricky shit on the internet? Because I use the internet. I feel like I use live streaming... No, I'm being serious, Jeff. My keyboard volume. All right. Well, fine. Maybe I've been by my keyboard volume. But the point is that I can't keep going on like this. I can't keep being this way. And I have to change. I have to genuinely try to change. Not just say it. Not just talk about it. Actually do it. Actually change for the better. And I need to live stream a bit less as well, in general. Well, maybe. I kind of enjoy live streaming a bit too much, but I need to provide more quality and be less narcissistic and just see this for what it is, just a fun activity in which I talk to people and get to know people and actually help people out. And when I get a difficult situation, I can figure out a way to overcome it. And I feel if I do that, I genuinely will be helping others instead of just saying it and not doing it. And I'll help myself too. Because, oh yeah, I can still be a tiny bit narcissistic, but there's nothing wrong with that. Everyone is a little self-serving in some way. It's just not doing it in ways that hurt other people. You know, I want to be seen as a... Spoiler, sweet friend, even when he's being genuine soul search, I'm still going to be taking the piss because that's what friends do to show we care. Also because you're a fucking nihilist, but still. And that's so... But yes, I appreciate that. That kind of attitude is why I stopped posting you and going to your streams. Nice to see you come to terms with that. I'm saying hello again. Oh, hello, Denomic_kitty_yo-yo. Wow, that's... Well, I can understand. I know. That's something I've heard over the years, even on Dope Whips. I still have screenshots of I like to say the underscores. I could just say dynamic kiddie, I suppose, couldn't I? But I've said that. Gameplay-wise, I've noticed you sometimes try to brute force one specific strategy in a hard fight rather than trying out a couple of different approaches, and then the brute force doesn't work. Well, that's exactly what that's exactly it, Scotty. That's just it. I've heard that line of criticism before, Scotty, and I've heard Denomic's line of criticism before as well. I've had screenshots from Dolphins in the past where I've had the same realization, and they'll say to me, your attitude is something that I got fed up of watching. I got tired of watching you rage and get pissed off at things. I stopped watching because you are just intolerable to watch, type of thing. I mean, yeah, Camel does the same, but the difference is that Camel overcomes it and beats it, and he also plays Doom better than me. He does play Doom better than me. He beat the Rage Machine on Ultraviolence, and I didn't. Because I didn't even try it. But... that's just it. You know, I don't try different strategies. I don't try different things. I know that I do that. I try this one approach, and when it fails, it's like I get pissed off. And then I try to, and then someone will come up with a suggestion how to beat the fight, and I'll beat it, and I'll be like, oh, that's how you do it. I don't think that sort of way to try a different scenario, to try out different active things, because I die the first time I try to. No, it doesn't work. Damn my head. Need a haircut, I think. Possibly. I need to lose weight. Lots of weight I need to lose. But that's another story, obviously. But it's one thing for you to say that, and it's now on me to actually have to do it. To realize when I'm trying one approach for a difficult fight, it's not working. Try something else. If you're wearing a ponytail, Draken, I would not be surprised. And it's another thing for me to recognize several times over the years that my rage, my autistic rage, and my narcissistic attitude is poor. But it's another thing for me to to actually carry it out. I want to try and be more pleasant to listen to on a general basis. I can't. Don't get him started, Roger. I can't sit here, Denomic Kitty, or anyone else, and say I'm not going to get upset at things. But I can sit here and say I'm going to try to acknowledge when I do get upset at things, and maybe take a pause for a moment, or do something other than just continue to act out the way I have. Maybe it's even just as simple as recognizing when I'm frustrated, and, well... yeah, that could help, but the thing is that the onus is on me to, I should recognize when, you know, I need to recognize myself, because people have done that in the past, Pineapple, they've genuinely have said that. The onus is on me to actually listen to them. To realize, yeah, this is getting a bit frustrating. Maybe I should just stop for a minute. Maybe I should just mute the microphone. And then take a break. Or try something different. Or maybe someone said this map's a bit difficult on Ultraviolence. Maybe you should try it on a lower difficulty setting. Now, we tried that with Wii with the P, Drowk, and it didn't work. I mean, if I had a bike in this room, I would do that, but the only bike is upstairs, and I don't have a camera tape with me or whatever. If I had the money for the technology, we could try something like that, where like I have a laptop with a camera or something, and I go upstairs. Yeah, that didn't really work out. Let's not. No, let's not. Let's just be healthy and go to the gym often and stop eating so much and stop using. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, because you're acknowledging it, and I think that's cool. So I'm going to be a genuine person. If I thought you were sure a narcissist, I would have followed you, but I hope you don't call yourself that. We all have narcissistic traits, but you're not all narcissists. There's a big difference between traits and the actual psychological order, which I would say you don't have. And yeah, I don't have full-blown narcissism. Let's be fucking clear, I don't. I just have traits of it, which my ex-father gave to me. You know, my ex-father's a fucking dickhead. Never meet him. Hope you never meet him. It's his fault. Peaceful voting for a peaceful. Two gets paused and the scream sale comes on for 2 minutes. That would make the average Benjogami map last about 5 hours. Start the map. Fuck! Pause! Pause! Okay, let's try it again. Fuck! Pause! You could make Benjogami with that kind of style. A Benjogami map could take 5 hours for an encounter that lasts 5 minutes on average. But it's I feel like I have had this narcissistic attitude in the across the streams, because when I'm streaming, I do act a little bit differently to when I do when I'm not streaming. When I'm, I don't get me wrong, I've done this with football too, but that usually involves alcohol and tribalism, and it's a little different there. Whales are raised in camels, those rage streams and peaceful mass creations. And cats! Yeah, because. Well, maybe there's something to that. There must be something to that. I just need to be able to calm down sometimes and think clearly. That's probably why I can't play these multiplayer games, because you don't get that option to pause and take a breather. You have to keep going, and it's like, that's not the best for me. God knows I'd love to be able to enjoy a game like that and have fun, like all the cool YouTubers do, playing these competitive games and not giving a shit for dying and just having a laugh. But I struggle to do that. But no, you are right, Dynamic Kitty. I'm not a full-blown narcissist, but I have a narcissistic thing. You know, I obsessively look at numbers of viewers and stuff like that. You know, but that's just me wanting to analyze statistics to say how well I'm doing. I don't really go like, oh shit, I've only had 20 viewers. That's really bad. That's why it's just I like to analyze statistics to see how well I'm doing. I want to get this channel to a point where I'm putting out good content. I care about putting out good content for people to enjoy. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. Yes, we still have to play Doom together, Fuzzball. I need to be a lot more social as well. I suck at socializing and networking. It's why I have Discord but barely use it. I'm terrible at that kind of stuff. Awful. Very shy when I'm not on a stream. Very awkward to deal with, but. Yeah, first time in 10 years, right, Drowken? Here's the first good content. Fuck you, Drowken. Fuck you. Go home. Go to bed. Go back to sleep. Yeah, I just can't handle the competitiveness. We'll go to bed then, Drowken. Rage jump, personal attacks. Yeah, I'm saying it in a joking way. And pussy is my. This is the banter me and Drow can have sometimes. Yeah, I mean, it's the for multiplayer games, it's the awkward sort of thing where it's like, I'd like to be able to play casually, but I take it seriously. Therefore, for a little while, it's only funny if I'm winning, but since I suck at most of these, I dialogue. And then I get upset, you know. As much as it'd be nice to be able to play these games, to enjoy them, to not give a shit as much about the losing part, I am horrendous. So horrendous at handling competitive games. Hey, Kyle, how's it going? Yeah, that's why I've enjoyed RuneScape, because it's very calm. I do boring shit, but it's what I enjoy. I like mining and smithing and cooking and killing things, knowing that it's not too difficult. I mean, maybe that doesn't happen later on, but whatever. That's just something I've wanted to do for a while, and it'd be nice. And I like the idea of the project. I'm sticking with that. But it is only a chill stream project. It's not gonna. It shouldn't be as frequent as it has been recently. But all right, see you later, Elkin. Have a good evening, man. I'm gonna be off to the pub in about half an hour too, or however long this takes. This kind of impromptu confession slash I'm sorry for being a dickhead stream. But that just come out of. Again, this could have been saved for Sweet State 5, but no, I'll probably talk about it briefly then too. But I do often wonder sometimes if I have to play a competitive game to try and learn how to not give a shit about dying, but I've tried so many times over the years and it's almost the same outcome. I enjoy it very briefly, and then I get into a difficult fight and I die, and that's it. I get pissed off and mad, and then I want to quit. I don't want to put in the time to learn the game, but I somehow want to be good at it. That's the hypocrisy of it all, I guess. That's why I don't bother anymore. I mean, I play Killing Floor 2 a lot. I know a decent amount of that, but that's not, that's a, again, that's probably part of it, but I just prefer to make stuff that other people enjoy. I prefer the live streaming thing. That's what I do. It's been such a tough time for me. Very few exceptions are not competitive or no tracking or anything. Hey, Flying Minister. I haven't seen you for a while. Hire someone to smack you in the testicles with a rule every time you die. You'll get good quickly, or I'll just stop playing. Or I'll just stop playing, which is what I have chosen to do. I just don't play those types of games anymore. I shouldn't be doing this as much as I do anyway, some of the time. I got other problems to deal with, but don't have the time I used to have, I should say. I just work most of the time. Fair enough. Well, that's fine. Electric shock. Nah, I need to sort out this trying to be a genuinely nicer streamer to watch. I want to be a streamer that people like find pleasant to listen to most of the time and doesn't go off on stupid, ragey tangents for no reason. That would be nice to achieve. I'm sure you would, but unless I was getting paid like some kind of torture porn style books for it, I don't think I'd enjoy it too much. I think it would. I think it'd be nice if like in the future when people, I mean, again, I know this is being a bit vain, but whatever, it's a point still. It'd be nice in the future when people think of my streams to think, oh, he's an alright player at Doom. He tries to help out new mappers. He's a nice guy. He's very constructive. Instead of thinking, oh, it's that guy who fucking rages at revenants and swears at people when he gets a bit mad. Fuck that guy. I'm gonna go watch someone who's a bit more reasonably can manage their emotions better and be calmer. I'm gonna go watch anyone else. Even Joe Ilya. Poor Joe. Not getting. I wish Joe got a bit more viewership, to be honest. But, oh well. That's the way it is. But, is there any further point to this stream anymore? I think I've kind of said my piece, maybe. I don't know, maybe. Alright, thank you for coming on by, Roger. Much appreciated. I shall see you around. Hand in there, Suitepee. Well, yeah, I do admit I watched a bit of the last one. He just seemed to have a not the best connection, but you can type. Yes, you can type, Karaja. I have some confidence. You can type very well. You can type extremely good. So, this is me kind of saying, I guess, aside from apologizing for all the mappers I've insulted in the past, for unnecessarily, quite a few of the top streamers on Twitch are raging idiots with the mentality of spoiled 90-year-olds. You're now anyone will cringe, feel proud. Yeah, I do a little bit, but, you know, they get paid to act stupid. That's the thing. They will know that they're getting paid a lot of money to be a certain way, and they'll be doing it on purpose. You know? I'm not getting paid any amount of money, really, to insult people, so why the fuck am I still doing it? And why should I do it in the first place? Doesn't mean he has to, I think that's what he means. Yeah. So this is me saying that from now on, although this is going to be a very hard process for me to change my behavioral patterns, and although I'm not going to be immediately super chill like a Nivanos or Mr. Zool or Mega Blast or King Dime or whatever, but this is me saying that from now on, I'm not going to want to be tolerating unfair personal attacks against mappers. That has to stop. Criticizing an encounter and injecting my own opinion on it, fair enough. You know, I'm not going to like every encounter for what it is. But claiming to have this attitude of I know best is poor. You know, I should just admit that I find this difficult. I don't understand why this is considered fun. But I acknowledge that it is fun for others. I need to get better at this and either beat it or avoid it. Not this attacking people's names for no stupid reason. Sounds good. I also just want to say, I hope you don't take what I said as an attack on you. I still value you because I think you're a good person. Just want to be honest because you are sharing this. How about doing some co-op doom? I could do some co-op doom. The only thing is, I'm not the biggest fan of some online doom because of lags and stuff, but I think if I play the right kind of stuff, I won't care about that. I like playing doom cooperatively. It's just the lag sometimes sucks, but I shouldn't really care about that type of stuff if I'm playing the right kind of setup, really. And co-op streams and co-commentary stuff's being planned for next year. Because although this is my form of escapism, I still want to try and put out some good content. I still take it quite seriously, which I don't think is necessarily a bad thing, as long as I realise also that I, A, do this too much sometimes, and B, when I do it, I want to be doing it in a happy, positively constructive way, 99.99% of the time. And hopefully going forward, especially into next year, it'd be nice if I could start making these changes. Like, for one thing, many various changes. Like, I lose weight. I stop swearing at stupid encounters in video games. I acknowledge when I'm frustrated and take a breather. I try different things. I maybe get back. I maybe get back the viewership of the Denomic Kiddies who are tired of watching an autistic rager swear and curse and get mad at nothing. And instead get them back on board because I'm a more genuinely pleasant experience to listen to and watch. You know? I'm not being a bit vain there, but nothing wrong with striving to be positive, right? And maybe one day, actually, hex and craps. That does sound interesting. Using alternate language or just stopping myself in the first place. I feel like, besides making me come across less angry or mean, it is just my own attitude. It's an interesting point. Hey, Gonhawk666, how you doing? Heck! That isn't vain. Recognizing your faults and trying to change is better is a good thing. And that's what I'm trying to do. And this is my stream, my impromptu stream, me telling everyone, I'm going to try harder to do that. Not just on the stream, but in my own personal life. I'm going to stop being, surround myself with negativity. You know, I've ditched my ex-father. I'm ditching my shitty job. And now I'm going to ditch my own shitty attitude that I sometimes express on stream and have done for years. And that's going to change. Slowly, yes, but surely. And that's just me being honest to you all. And to myself. And that was very hard for me to do. You know, I can't live in this bubble anymore. I really can't. But that doesn't mean that sometimes... But that doesn't mean I have to give up my escapism. I just have to change it so that this escapism is healthier for me in general. And I'll talk about that a bit more on Sweet State 5, which I don't know when I'm going to do it now. It'll either be before or after Christmas. But I'll probably mention a bit of this stuff then. And I'll probably keep this as a highlight as well. Because I think it deserves to be saved as such. Because of all this was very repetitive and rambly. And I said the same points quite a few times. I feel that I've made a point that I need to remember this time and actually act upon. So, let's see what happens next, shall we? Yeah, you can hold me to it. And if I do act like a prick, tell me. Maybe I'll get the message then. I do feel that over the years, I've helped to build up a small and respectable audience that do want to watch the stuff I put out. And I only owe it to them to put out good stuff that they want to keep coming back for and listening to. And I feel it's very unfair for me to carry on in this vein anymore. Because one day I do want to be as popular and as numerically, you know, that's what I've strived for years when making this channel. I want to have as much viewership as King Diamond enjoys. Genuinely do. That is a target I have always wanted to achieve ever since I started this. He was my major influence for making this channel in the first place. Watching his Doom stuff, watching the old Doom streams and realizing... I'd like to give that a shot. Self-reflection can be a difficult thing. It's go uphill so you don't possess the views by this first step to bend yourself and be taken wrong. You won't be willing to quit, but it's warning in itself. Yeah. I think you've summed it up pretty well there, Flying Minister. I think you've summed it up pretty well. I do have a decent amount of self-reflection, but now it's time for action. Because one day I really hope to have, you know, I might get a partnership on Twitch. That'd be nice. To be a respected live streamer with 100 plus viewers on a regular basis who is happy with himself, who is happy towards his audience, who has earned respect. Because they're a nice person, because they don't act like an asshole, they don't swear at people and say stupid shit that they regret 5 seconds later. Now, wouldn't that be nice? Instead of how I've been acting a good chunk of the time. I think the first thing I can do is to acknowledge I'm not as good at Doom as I think I am. And I'm not as knowledgeable at Doom as I think I am. And there's a lot of maps and mods I'm going to play in the future that are going to test me in different ways. And I should just embrace that. You can do it. I actually stream you as a live stream version of the view website, but specifically for all things Doom. And I am thinking of making a couple of changes for streaming in the future. One of them being doing a bit less of it, but We'll see. I have plans. My main thing for now is to get my is to be happier and more confident again, and this is part of it. I feel I owe. This is part of the process. To be honest with you all, to talk to you all, to let it be clear. I'm going to do all the stuff next year that I will mention out in Sweet State 5. I'm hyping up Sweet State 5 a little bit here, but this was more a stream, just an ears impromptu. I just had to get some off my chest almost, and I feel hopefully going forward this is something I can look back on with some. It'll be nice if, like, I don't know, two or three years from now, I'm doing a Sweet State, and I say to you, and I'm saying to you all, do you remember that time just before Christmas of 2018? By the way, not here, but in my own house as well. That'd be fucking sweet. It'd be nice in like 2 or 3 years. I'm looking back at, I'm doing a Sweet State in my own house. I'm thinner, happier, and I'm saying, do you remember like 2 years ago in Christmas of, before Christmas of 2018, when I just did a stream or I just rambled into a microphone for an hour and a half about how much of a narcissistic asshole I was? And I listened to people and I told everyone and I said I was going to change. And look at me now. I have become that positive change that I've wanted for my sake and for everyone else's sake too. That would be nice. I still have a beard though. I think this beard wouldn't change. But I'd be much thinner. My glasses probably would be the... Well, these will probably have changed too by then. And I might have different headphones. And the mic will probably still be the same. And I'd be 35, 36. But I'd be smiling a lot more. Big smile on my face. And there'd be two girls over here. Girlfriend 1 and girlfriend 2. And I'd have a rich car. And a pile of money in the background, which I'd point to every 5 minutes and go, oh, I'm just going to reach into my stack of money. Piles of cash. And a flying pig would occur and fly up over behind me. And this map makes me cry. Wipes tears with money. I'd just take out like a £5 note, a Churchill, and just... I wish I had, she had a £5 note now. Where's my wallet? That's upstairs. Fuck. I missed an opportunity there to make a joke. Oh, well. I won't do that. Should that be a bit awkward? That also has my real name on it. So, oh, time went 8:45. Shit, I better get cracking. It's not John! Gasp. No, my first name is John. That was leaked years ago. Accidentally, I was doing a stream and I brought up like the status bar and it said John on it, and then everyone knew my first name, but my second name remains a mystery, thankfully. Except for those that know me. For now, anyway. There may come a point in the future where I'll be a bit more honest about that too, but not at this moment. It is as far as you need to know. Yes, Suitepee is my real surname. I'm John Suitepee. I go around and insult people with my second name. You know, my name's John. John Suitepee. You know, I'm like, how dare you say that? It's offensive. No, it's my real name. Nah, you're getting kicked out. Get out. I'm sorry, pineapple. I'm sorry. At least you're still a sentient pineapple. That's a relief. Oh, God. Right, well, I think this stream has served its purpose. Well, as far as I'm concerned, the stream has served its purpose now. I've ranted, I've been honest, I've apologised to every mapper, I've made my point several times, probably. So, now comes the extended litmus test. Can I do this from now on? We will see. It's going to be hard, but I'm going to do it. So, thank you all for watching. I much appreciate it. I know this has not been Doom or RuneScape or any other tiny little game in between those two. Other games exist? I don't know. But hopefully going forward, anyone who takes the time to watch this channel is going to find a hopefully more positive experience. But I still will rage at Revenants and I'll still fucking hate them. But maybe I just won't. For God's sake. I've pulled my heart out for an hour and a half. And all you have to mention is Thief 2. That's it. Fuck Thief 2, I'm done. I'm done with Thief 2. I'm done with it. No more. I'm not playing it anymore. I'm done. No more. Yoga with Suitepee. Oh, I doubt I could bend my legs to do yoga. Hot yoga streams. Yeah, just there I am with my man boobs out doing yoga. That would just be weird. Gades! Yeah. Maybe. Can't rule it out. But that will probably more likely to happen when I get my own place. And I can set up my own bedroom and maybe put some creative shit into it. You know, have a background with some cool pictures in it, like a Doom poster or whatever. That'd be nice. Then you can come visit. Yes, you can. And we can play Pokemon games. We can play Pokemon cards. And you can beat me because you've practiced. And I can flip the table and tell you that the card game is bullshit and leave. Doom 2052. Could play that, sure. Absolutely. But that'll be 2 or 3 years from now, hopefully. 2 or 3 years from now. Alright. Yes, I'll play Thief 2, Dave, alright? It's one of many things that are going to happen one day on this channel. If only you'd stop asking. So, now I'm officially ending the stream. The stream is ending now. No more distractions. Thank you all for watching. Thank you all for your input for this hour and a half session. I do appreciate each and every one of you for taking the time to listen to this 33-year-old try to improve his life and the life of those that he around him. And I hope to actually provide that for you in the coming years instead of just saying it, actually doing it for you. You'll believe it when you see it. Go get drunk. Gains. Yes, gains! Lots of gains! Let's go all fit. See you all soon. I'll try and do a stream tomorrow evening at some point. And it will be a Doom stream, if it is. I'll actually play some Doom. Which, at this point, might be a bit naughty. Bye, everyone. Thanks for watching. See you later. Punch the screen. Punch it!